I found her in a cat house off the Blue Ridge Parkway, a cozy little den of low expectations where the Johns have beady eyes and scrunched noses like an invisible hand is pie-facing them, and has been since Rutherford split the atom. A little bird told me a girl named Cleona Shaw could tell me the truth about what happened to Mr. Regular, but I couldn't shake the feeling I was tooting the wrong ringer. What could some 19-year-old twist tell a fella about his world? 19 is too new. 19 is still slick with mama's gel. I told the madam to take a powder, pressing a sawbuck into her palm to keep her blind, deaf, and dumb while I tightened the screws on Cleona. I entered the room and there she was, 5 feet 3 inches of honey, the sort of dame who says yes and means it.
Hello there, detective. Beautiful evening, isn't it?
I'm not exactly keen on the dark, or the small talk. Make with the wisdom or I'll have you under glass thicker than the Last Supper.
You private dicks sure are testy. You know, you might do a thing or two about the goon situation around here. Girl's been getting roughed up.
I'll call in some black and whites and have them look into it.
Who do you think's doing all the roughing? Why aren't you ever here when us girls need you?
Maybe you could start needing me when I'm actually around.
What are you here for, anyway? Playing gumshoe for some nervous housewife? Can't keep her husband at home?
I'm looking for Regular.
And what makes you think I know where he is?
Because a little birdie told me you've been stalking Old Crow, and I'm not quite so slow as to think you enjoy drinking anything with a kick to it. You want these people to think you're strawberry schnapps, but you're kid stuff. You're strawberry milk and a plate of Lorna Doones. Now where's Regular?
All right. He was here, not about an hour ago. Not for that, but for what I know.
Spill it, toots.
I had a John a few nights back, name of Pat Coyne. He got to bragging, saying Regular couldn't piece it all together, that him and his boys had been behind it all.
Behind what?
The murder of the American mid-engine car.
Who is Coyne?
I don't know. Mr. Coyne's been coming for a few months. Actually, Mr. Regular left this behind. Don't know what it is, but maybe it'll be useful to you.
She let out a giggle, and I let out a little weariness with this world, where a doll-faced kid has no familiarity with the color of innocence, before innuendo was a second language unto itself. I remember the world as it was, before the stony grays and ink blacks blended into a muted, uniform monotone, before the sharp edges of ambition were sanded down to whip-smooth corners, like the skin of some newborn babe with no expectation of the world ahead, no rosy picture of the world before. I remember what it was like when Lady Luck still saw Johns. Now she's out of the trade, having married herself to men with money and influence. Nothing for the hoods or the jobby slinging spuds and hash houses off the interstate. Lady Luck sold out, and she's too rich for my blood. I knew it would be a long night ahead. Well, what is this thing? I'd better listen to it. Could hold the key to everything.
I saw visions of possibility. I saw a past prophecy. Dragged through road salt and never hosed off, not even at the dollar do-it-yourself wash, next to the secondhand smoke roller rink and a foul-mouthed dry cleaner. For a year or two, Lady Luck was on our side in the 1980s. The 1980s, an alternate future past. Firebirds beget fieros, and the sun rose on this rain-soaked front engine farce of an American sports car scene. We had it, Roman. We had it. This was supposed to be the new future. This was supposed to be what America could have been. We had it. America had our own mid-engine car, and we weren't copying the Orientals. This was Yankee Doodle through and through. Damn, Roman, you should have seen her. She had those eyes that did that thing to me. Curves where you wanted them. And even in places where you didn't know you wanted them. This was the kind of dame who you wanted to wake up next to. But once she got fresh with that ham and eggs heavy petting, see, any hope of going back to cabbage face factory girls took a dirt nap. We had it, Roman, we had it. Maybe the French professor used his quantum accelerator to open a portal to another world, an alternate reality America where we embrace small, wedgy runabouts. Then Coyne came in. Coyne came in, dropped off a file, adjusted the inputs and protractor outputs. My readings were weird. I couldn't figure it out. But hear me, Roman, hear this. Coyne did it. Only he had the moxie to deep six his original angelic creation. He made it. He made her. And then he killed her. But I didn't want to believe it. This was supposed to be the for maybe an alternate America of the America we could have had. An America where George McGovern won. We were still the same country we always were, but the rest of the world liked us. We could go to the European Union and not get hassled. We would compete in all those little rallies. You know, maybe not win, but at least have some respect. It's a mid-engine car, yeah, and I know that's what we weren't used to. But those little gauges right there? Ah, that's so American right there. Crooked dog-legged shifter, V6 instead of a 4, trumpet exhaust, that's how they came, man. Fiero, fiery, like the Phoenix. A rebirth, but not for us. Not for this America. Coyne wanted to make sure his version of the truth won. He had to make sure front engine, rear-wheel drive, V8 in the front, burnouts in the back, stayed true. If his version of the truth was proven false, everything would fall apart. I know it's hard to stomach, but this is the version we have to take, and this is the version we're stuck with. I'll meet back up with you at the waypoint, and we'll figure out what we're going to do from here. End transmission.
A thought can flower into an idea into a brand into a legacy, and round into an ideology. But these are all things that are difficult to kill individually, much less in tandem. Coyne. A brand, an ideology, the mechanism of demand, the American mid-engine car. Who would have the motive? Who would stand to gain from this murder? Coyne. Pat Coyne. It was...
before we go into noir
music.
I love the dog. It's just like,
dog had no idea what's going on.
It was so good though.
Yeah. Just leave that cut in.
Oh, that's gonna be over the
credits. Yeah.